Hi everyone and welcome to my channel Hube Tabibi. This video of mine is about furuncle and carbuncle. Furuncle, which is simply called as bile, is a painful pus-filled bump that forms under your skin when bacteria infect and inflame one or more of your hair follicles. A carbuncle is a cluster of boils that form a connected area of infection under the skin. Earlier I posted a short video about these on my channel. I hope you have already seen that video. And today I am going to discuss this illness in detail. Well, boils or furuncles usually start as red, tender bumps. The bumps quickly fill with pus, growing larger and more painful until they rupture and drain. Areas most likely to be affected are the face, back of the neck, armpits, thighs, and buttocks. You can usually care for a single bile at home, but do not attempt to pick or squeeze it because in that case they may spread the infection. Now I will tell you the symptoms. Regarding boils, they can occur anywhere on your skin but appear mainly on the face, back of the neck, armpits, thighs and buttocks and hair bearing areas where you are most likely to sweat or experience friction. Signs and symptoms of a bile usually include a painful red bump that starts out small and can enlarge to more than 2 inches, that is 5 centimeters. Red swollen skin around the bump, an increase in the size of the bump over a few days as it fills with pus, development of a yellow-white tip that eventually ruptures and allows the pus to drain out. Regarding carbuncle, it's a cluster of boils that form a connected area of infection. Compared with single boils, carbuncles cause a deeper and more severe infection and are more likely to leave a scar. People who have a carbuncle often feel unwell in general and may experience a fever and chills. You usually can care for a single small bile yourself, but see your doctor if you have more than one bile at a time or if a bile occurs on your face or affects your vision, or if it worsens rapidly or is extremely painful, or it causes a fever, gets bigger and despite self-care, or if it has not healed in 2 weeks, or if it reoccurs. Okay. Now I'll tell you the causes. Most boils are caused by Staphylococcus aureus, which is a type of bacterium commonly found on the skin and inside the nose. A bump forms as pus collects under the skin. Boils sometimes develop at sites where the skin has been broken by a small injury or an insect bite, which gives the bacteria easy entry. Now I will tell you the risk factors. Although anyone, including otherwise healthy people, can develop boils or carbuncles, there are some factors which can increase your risk. First factor is that if you have a close contact with a person who has a staph infection, you are more likely to develop an infection if you live with someone who has a bile or carbuncle. Diabetes. This disease can make it more difficult for your body to fight infection, including bacterial infection of your skin. Other skin conditions. Because they damage your skin protective barrier, skin problems such as acne and eczema make you more susceptible to bile and carbuncle. Well, regarding acne, I have already uploaded a video about acne on my channel. That is a very informative video and you can see that video. Also, there is another risk factor, that is compromised immunity. If your immune system is weakened for any reason, you are more susceptible to bile and carbuncles. Now I will tell you the complications. Rarely, bacteria from bile or carbuncle can enter your bloodstream and travel to other parts of your body. The spreading infection, commonly known as blood poisoning, that is sepsis, can lead to infections deep within your body, such as your heart, that is endocarditis, and if it infects bone, then it is known as osteomyelitis. Now I will tell you some preventive measures. It is not always possible to prevent boils, especially if you have a weakened immune system. But the measures which I am going to tell you may help you avoid staph infections. First of all, you should wash your hands regularly with mild soap or use an alcohol-based hand rub often. Careful hand washing is your best defense against germs. Keep wounds covered. Keep cuts and abrasions clean and covered with sterile dry bandages until they heal. Also, you should avoid sharing personal items. Do not share towels, sheets, razors, clothing, athletic equipment and other personal items. Staph infections can spread via objects as well as from person to person. If you have a cut or sore, wash your towels and linens using detergent and hot water with added bleach and dry them in a hot dryer. Now I will tell you about the diagnosis of bile and carbuncles. Okay. Well, when the patient comes to us, we are likely to be able to diagnose a bile or bile or carbuncle simply just by looking at it. A sample of the pus may be sent to the lab for testing. This may be useful if you have reoccurring infections or an infection that has not responded to a standard treatment. Many varieties of the bacteria that cause bile have become resistant to certain types of antibiotics, so lab testing can help determine what type of antibiotic work best in your situation. Now I will tell you about the treatment. You can generally treat small bile at home by applying warm compresses to relieve pain and promote natural drainage. For larger bile and carbuncles, treatment may include incision and drainage. Your doctor may drain a large bile or carbuncle by making an incision in it. Deep infections that cannot be completely drained may be packed with sterile gauze to help soak up and remove additional pus. Antibiotics. Sometimes your doctor may prescribe antibiotics to stop to help heal severe or recurrent infections. I mean, sometimes when infection is severe, we prescribe antibiotics for healing. Okay. Now I will tell you some lifestyle and home remedies which are very important to note. For small boils, the measures which I am going to tell you may help the infection heal more quickly and prevent it from spreading. First is warm compresses. Apply a warm washcloth or compress to the affected area several times a day for about 10 minutes each time. This helps the bile rupture and drain more quickly. Also, you should never squeeze or lance a bile yourself. This can spread the infection. You know, sometimes people are in a habit of pricking their small bile, so I mean that can spread infection to other areas of the body. So do not attempt to squeeze these biles, or also you should not lance a bile yourself. Okay. Also, you should prevent contamination. You should wash your hands thoroughly after treating a bile. Also, launder clothing, towels or compresses that have touched the infected areas, especially if you have recurrent infections. Well, this was my video about furuncle and carbuncle. I hope you like this video. If you have these issues, you can post your comment and I will try to reply to your comment as soon as possible. If you or your family member or some friend or friends suffering from any illness for which you cannot find a video, because on my channel with BB I have posted so many videos about different illnesses and you can see all those videos. But if you want me to upload a video about a specific illness, for that video is not already there, then you can post your comment and if I find a time, I'll try to make a video about that particular illness as soon as possible. Thanks for watching this video. See you in next video. Bye for now.